Good evening, friends, and I'm indeed honored and grateful to the Rotary Club and the Rotarians from South Asia and world over for having me here. and also I must thank Rotary for being a constant partner with MV Foundation. In fact, one of the earliest honors I have received is from Rotary India, you know, and I was decorated by the Rotary, and I cherish it as a very special award. I don't know why it doesn't get mentioned, but I must tell you that you have awarded me, and I cherish it very much.
How much time do you have?
It's a secret conversation I had. I wanted to know how much time I had. And the issue of education, I'm really glad that the Rotary clubs have decided to take up the literacy mission. I think if there has to be a difference in the country, and if there has to be a great leap forward, that can happen only with education and only with literacy. And if it comes to the Rotary and its mind, to the Rotarians and their mind, that this is important, I know it will happen. You did it with polio. I don't see why you cannot do it with education. In fact, I must say that this idea of education is so important that I might just give you some examples from MV Foundation that I have been associated with. We have been able to bring some 1 million children to schools, 10 lakh children to schools, and we followed up with all of them till they completed class 10. They were both girls and boys. We had to stop some 20,000 child marriages. We had to release some 20,000 children as bonded laborers. We had to get children who were trafficked back home without getting stigmatized and see that they get their ART treatment for HIV and AIDS. So what I'm trying to tell you is the work on education is not an easy work, which all of you know. It is ridden with conflicts, and if we have brought 1 million children back to school, we have resolved 1 million conflicts. It's not a soft program. It's a hard program, and it's a program of resolving conflicts, resolving tension, and in fact, unraveling hidden power structures that operate in keeping children out of schools. And that is what we have learned to do in MV Foundation. For example, we decided that there cannot be any enemies in this program. Many people who work on child labor are in an adversarial position against the employers or the school teachers or the government or the parents, and they think that all of them are no good. Our program starts on the assumption that everyone is an ally, that everyone is a partner. This is exactly what I think Rotary is doing and has been doing all the time, that expanding its base and building its alliance. To give you an example, there was a girl who in fact was running an evening motivation center. Let's call her Major Bean. Now this girl, you know, the employer came to attack her with an axe, saying that she was trying to mobilize community to take away his bonded labor, a very small boy. Now, all children in the motivation center protected her. The next day, she was traveling in a bus, and she found this man and asked him, "What did I do so wrong that you wanted to kill me?" But afterwards, she felt that she didn't do a right thing in insulting him in public in the bus in that manner. So she went back to him and she said, I should not have done that. And in fact, if you just release the bonded laborer, we will honor you. And so did he. And he released the bonded laborer, and there was a huge function in the village where they honored him, and he did something called a Vidyadan. And there was a Vidyadan ceremony that was held where he gave plates and spoons, I'm sorry, school bags and others to the boy and said that now you go and study. Another example I would like to give to tell you how consensus is built. There was a school teacher who was employing a boy in his farm. So we are talking about out-of-school children where the employers could be school teachers as well. And he said to us, when he brought this child back into his classroom and did a bridge course for the child, got him to learn, he said it was like a Divyanubhuti that he realized God. He said, every day I went for a bhajan. Every Friday I went for a bhajan, but I didn't know what God was. But when I found this boy whom I released and who is now in my class and who is along with others in class 5, I felt that God is with me. You know, this is the kind of journey that bringing education actually means. It's a very spiritual journey, a journey that touches everyone, but a journey that is ridden with conflicts and a journey that where we will have to resolve conflicts. It's not a soft program. Getting a child out of school is getting him out of child labor. That we must know. And we will have to respect the last volunteer, trust him, because he is the one who's taking the risk to get the child back into the school system. And we have to give them all independence, all autonomy to take the decision, because it can never be a centralized program. It has to be a decentralized program because it starts there at the level. It has to be planning for every child. And I'm sure that when you did a polio drop, you planned for every drop in every child. It couldn't have been otherwise. It's as important as a polio drop that you touch every child to get the child back to school. But when you do that, you build a consensus. You cannot build consensus in a vacuum. You cannot put a beautiful poster and say, I liked what Mr. Ravindran said, that it is a combination of a macro and a micro. Surely conferences are important, placards are important, publicity is important, but then micro, the mouse and the bird have to be there to get to see both the worlds and to do what is necessary. So here, I think the support has to be to that last volunteer who's facing the risk. We were itching for conflicts when we were working on this issue. We felt that if there is no conflict, then there is no building of alliances. If there is no building of alliances, there's no building of consensus. The process of building of consensus is a process of resolving conflicts. They're not two isolated, two compartmentalized issues. They're both together. So this is one point I would like to make. The second point I would like to make is that there is a thing of building a social movement, an environment, a mood. It has to be a madness. It cannot be a program where we are not mad. It's a crazy program. You know, like we are all mad. That is why we are here. We are now mad about children. That's why we are here. We are all mad about children's education. That's why I was here. And if we were normal, we wouldn't be here. So let's believe in the fact that there's a lot of madness involved in this. And that madness must be all pervasive. In fact, since the last 1 hour, I was stimulated. You know, I've just retired and I said, now enough is enough. But I go back with so much energy. I came empty-handed, but I pick up so much energy from you to do more and think that there's no point in retiring. Let me capture this madness and pass it on to some 1,000 others. And that's how we committed to the 20,000 children. You gave us the courage to do more. And we will. We will do more. And this requires being a little, a quirk in the mind. And that passion is so necessary. And trust the youth. Trust their capacity. trust them. I mean, so somehow I feel the future is them. We just had a minister for youth, and I really wanted him to give a statement that he will develop at least 1 million youth volunteers for education, for RLIM mission, and that should be his statement for the day. Unfortunately, he left before I made the speech. You know, as a youth minister, he should pledge that he will sort of see that the NSS program, every program takes up education and be partners to the Rotary Club. And it's so important to have that movement. Along with the movement, there is a process of institution building. If you leave a mobilization without building institution, then the movement is lost like a bubble. We will have to strengthen the gram panchayats. We will have to strengthen the school management committees. We will have to trust the school teacher, never blame him, and tell him that you can't do, but always tell him you can. And take him along with us. We have to trust the teachers' unions and build strong local institutions to see that children go to school. So a movement must continuously or simultaneously build institutions to enable this act. The last thing I want to tell you is that what is it that we are trying to do when we are doing education? You know, I know, but I would like to say it again. I said it 100 times, 1,000 times, 1 lakh times. It's like saying a prayer. I'll say it again. Now, what we are trying to do is give the child her dignity when she is educated. It's not just that. It is breaking the cycle of poverty. That is what we are doing when we are talking education. It is bringing equality or bridging inequities in society. That is what education is about. It is deepening of democracy. That is what education is about. You know, democracy is more than voting right. Democracy has to be equality. Democracy has to be social justice. Without education, there is neither equality nor social justice. There is some kind of, I always feel, an education apartheid going on in this country. The haves have it, the have-nots don't. This breaks the education apartheid in the country. When every child is in the school, then, you know, like one of those girls in Andhra hostels, she climbed Mount Everest. She's just 13 years. All of us can dream of climbing Mount Everest. That is what education is about. It's a great equalizer. It can really build democracy. It can deepen democracy. It can give children their rights. And you are part of a great radical revolutionary agenda. I would think of it as more revolutionary than the polio program, because it's really, I think, something, it's so transformatory. And we are so happy in the MV Foundation to be part of each one of you. Let's expand our family. Let this atmosphere in this room become the atmosphere in the country, and let's build a great nation. Thank you.